Mighty one, I will send our fears of men. Father, we bless your name, Lord. We give you our faith, God. Who is like unto our Lord, who can be compared to him? Thank you, Father, that time that is in his presence. Unto the Lord. See, as such as do wickedly against the covenant shall he corrupt by flattery, for the people that do know their God shall be strong and do exploit. My brother, you will know your God in the name of Jesus. You will be strong in the name of Jesus, and you will do exploit in the name of Jesus, walking in the knowledge of God. That's my mission this hour. Just in the next 20, 30 minutes or so, I'm off here because I just want us to pray. And my prayer is that this year you will walk in the knowledge of God in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every grace you need is available for you. You just need to tap into that grace. The Bible says the grace of God is sufficient for every one of us. The grace is there for you to tap into. In 2 Peter 3:18. He said, but grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Growing in the grace and knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. My brother, this year you will grow in the grace and knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ in the name of Jesus. You will grow in grace. You will grow in knowledge. You will grow in understanding of the Lord Jesus Christ in the name of Jesus. He said to him, be glory both now and to day of eternity. Growing in grace, growing in knowledge, growing in understanding. As a Christian, we need to grow in grace, which has been made available to us. We need to grow in knowledge. We need to grow in understanding. We need to grow in the things of God. He said, he's often said, knowledge and power. Anything that can is too big, or if you lack any knowledge, go to God. Go to God. No one is an island. You need to read, you need to study, you need to ask, you need to seek the face of God. Most of us behave ignorantly because we don't acquire knowledge, because we don't seek knowledge, because we don't go to God in the place of asking, in the place of seeking. There are certain privileges you enjoy when you operate in the knowledge of God. And those privileges are not available for those who don't operate in that realm. The knowledge of God brings inner strength to every one of us. Understanding the knowledge and walking in knowledge will bring inner strength unto you. It's also the key to your stability. In Isaiah chapter 33, verse 6. It is the key to your stability. It says, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy time. And that will be your portion in the name of Jesus. It says, strength of salvation, the fear of the Lord is his treasure. It says, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy time. And strength of salvation, the fear of the Lord is his treasure. So there's certain privilege you enjoy when you bring the knowledge of God. So I say it gives you that strength. It is also the key to your stability. So you walk in the knowledge of God. You walk in the strength of God. You walk in the ability of God. You walk in the grace that has been made available. The Bible says those that are led by the Spirit of God, they are the ones that are called the sons of God. So you need to be led by the Spirit of God. This period of time, this period of our life, we need to understand the things of the Spirit and allow the Spirit of God to direct the affairs of our life. And that's my prayer for you, that you will walk in the Spirit of God in the name of Jesus. That you allow the Spirit of God direct the affairs of your life in the name of Jesus. Also, walking in knowledge is also enhances our deliverance. There are certain things you don't understand. Like what we're like in the Bible school, in the Sunday school this morning, we're talking about that when you get to the end of the road, you feel going to consult medium is the best bet for you. But when you walk in the knowledge of God, you understand the place of prayer. You understand the place of going back to that same God. There is nothing that happened to a man that God does not know about. He is the Almighty God, the all-knowing God. The Bible says the secret things are his. That which he wants us to know are revealed unto us. So why won't you go to the one that the secret things are his? What other thing are you looking for that you cannot find in him that created those things? He is the creator of heaven and earth. He chose to make heaven his throne and the earth his footstool. We can't question him. Praise God. Amen. So how do you obtain knowledge of God? By studying the word of God. You obtain knowledge in the place of study. If you look at John chapter 1, verse 1, he said, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. That same word is the name God. He said, the same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was nothing that was made that was made. So there's just nothing that was made that was not made by him. He knows everything. So why go to somewhere else to seek knowledge? Why consult things that you don't consult? All these things have been made available. Why not tap into it? So you're generally in the place of studying the word of God, in the place of listening to the word of God and the message, and the place of attending fellowship like this. Suppose they will tell you, my method of worship is listening to messages. The Bible says, don't no, forsake the assemblies of brethren. It's good to listen to messages. It's good to watch programs on YouTube, to listen to services on YouTube. But if that's a pattern, there's something wrong somewhere. The word of God cannot be wrong. He said we should not forsake the assemblies of brethren. Praise God. You also need to live a life of prayer. In Luke chapter 18, you acquire knowledge in the place of prayer. He said, he speaks very well to them, to this end, that men always ought to pray and not what? Faint. So you acquire knowledge in the place of prayer, constant prayer, pray without ceasing. See, men ought always to pray. Praise God. My prayer that he said you will pray like never before. There is nothing that prayer cannot solve. No matter the situation, no matter the crisis, no matter what you are going through, you get solution in the place of prayer. You are not deceived that there's other way around it. No. The Bible says, ask, it shall be given. He says, seek, you will find. He said, knock, and the door shall be opened unto you. So you do not receive because you don't ask, but you ask amiss. So this year, learn how to pray. Learn how to ask. Acquire knowledge. Go to God. Seek his face. Ask of him. All we need is in him. Not in any other thing. All that you need is in God. Is in your Creator. He has made it available for me and you. All we need to do is to tap into it. If God is not doing it, no one else can do it. No one else can deceive you. So that's why it's amazing to visit all manner of places, seeking for help, all manner of things. You get them in the place of studying. You get yourself in the place of prayer. No one else can help you out. Even when you go to all these people, all these medium and people, and you consult with these things for you, if you say you want to kill someone, they will hand over that knife to you, and you will be the one that will stab that person. They have to do this to call up the image of that one being. They will not help you. Why is that? They do. They are not being for you. Why? They call up the image of the woman and say, take the knife, you stab the person. Why did they do it for you? He that live by the sword will die by the sword. There's no two way around about it. For so a man sweat that he reaps. So you feel you don't want to seek knowledge from God in the place of study, in the place of prayer. You feel you want to go somewhere else. You get a result of going to somewhere else. So prayer is the basic necessity for our successful life. Nothing else. The basic necessity for our successful life is prayer. Learn how to pray. Learn how to thank God. Learn how to worship him. Learn how to praise him. In it is your blessing. In that is your miracle. In that is your healing. In that is your deliverance. In that is your restoration. Nothing more than that. Prayer is the master key. When you pray, you get direction. When you pray, you are more courageous. Prayer prepares you for the future. It keeps you from sin, and it keeps you in the place of prayer constantly. So you acquire the place of prayer. You get courage in the place of prayer. You get understanding in the place of prayer. You get revelation in the place of prayer. What you cannot get in the place of prayer, you cannot get it anywhere else. So you get direction. There are sometimes you do certain things that you wonder, how did you do it? What happened? But God has revealed that unto you. So it makes it easier for you. So you also get revelation in the place of prayer. You also need to have faith. In what's right, a man, if you have faith in it, it will work for you. That is it. You must have faith in what you're doing. You must have faith in what you believe in. If you believe you call on the Lord Jesus to answer you, you must have faith in Him. Without faith, you can't serve God, you can't please God, you can't do His will. What does the Bible tell us in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6? He said, faith is seeing the invisible and doing the incredible and explaining the impossible. So you need to have faith. Without faith, you can't please God. Without faith, you cannot serve God. Without faith, you cannot do His will. Praise God. So you, this year, have faith in what you are doing. Believe God. Hebrews 11, he said, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, and the evidence of things not seen. He said, for by it the elder obtained a good report. He said, through faith we understand that the world were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do not appear. So this year, have faith in God. Operate in the realm of faith. In Hebrews 6, 11, verse, he said, but without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For he that cometh to God must believe that He is, and that He is the rewarder of them that diligently seek Him. So when you must come to God in faith, when you pray, you must have faith in your prayer that I have asked that God will bring it to pass. The Bible says, no, it will tarry, it will surely come to pass. For everything is for an appointed time. When the time comes, nothing can stop it. Sometimes we are in a hurry. But the Bible says 1,000 years is just like a day. So why in a hurry? What God is not doing, no one else can do for you. No one else. If you want to use your own wisdom, you will fail. If you want to use your own knowledge, you will fail. If you want to walk in the hand of your flesh, you will fail. So faith moves God in action in you. It guarantees victory over your enemy, and it's also the key to removing the mountains. The Bible says, if you have faith like that mustard seed, you will speak to that mountain be moved and cast into the sea. But you must have faith to speak the word into that situation. My prayer that he said, we'll have faith in what we're doing in the word of God, in the things of God, in the name of Jesus. How can you access those faiths? You can access it in hearing the word, eating the word, speaking the word, acting the word. You need to act the word. You need to speak the word. You need to eat the word. You need to hear the word. In 1 Corinthians, I want to read chapter 9, verse 16. He said, for though I preach the gospel, I have nothing to glory. For necessity is laid upon me. Yea, woe is unto me if I preach not the gospel. Knowledge comes to the place of soul winning. Let's be soul winner this year. Some of us who are shy to go out there to preach the gospel, even to hand out leaflets to people. That's the whole duty of man. Soul winning. Preaching the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. In that same Second Corinthians chapter 9, verse 6 to 8. He said, but this I say, he which soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he which soweth bountifully shall also reap bountifully. Every man according as it was said in his heart, so let him give not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that ye always having all sufficient in all things may abound to every good work. He also learn how to sow, learn how to give to the things of God. Praise God. Learn how to sow, learn how to give to the things of God. There is blessing in giving. The hand of the giver is always on top. Praise God. God rewards your giving. It rewards your faith. It rewards all that you do in His name. There is blessing in it. My prayer, this year we'll learn how to serve God in our giving in the name of Jesus. God commands us to give. He commands us to submit to His Lordship. He commands us to trust Him for His provision. Nothing is free anyhow and anywhere. I keep saying it. There will be something in your heart for God to bless. God will not bless nothing. So you are the type that, I was sharing with someone some time ago. He said, does not even have enough. So why would you be giving to God? I just laugh. I think this one has not started. You remain where you are. It's not a curse. It's that they won't have. So what am I giving? When the widow was asked to bring all those vessels, as far as the vessels stop, the oil also cease. There must be something in your hand for God to bless. You don't come to God empty. If you come to God empty, you go empty. Praise God. My brother will not come to God empty this year in the name of Jesus. We understand the secret of giving. In your giving is your blessing. Isaiah 15 verse 8 says, then shall your light break forth like the dawn, and your healing shall spring up speedily. Your righteousness shall go before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Praise God. That will be our portion in the name of Jesus. But sometimes we want to enjoy all these things. They are free. But conditions are also attached to it. Praise God. Bible says if you hearken and obedience. If you don't hearken and there's no obedience in there, you can't enjoy the blessing that goes with the word of God. There will be a sacrifice to pay. In Isaiah 55 verse 12, Isaiah 55 verse 12, he said, for you shall go out in joy. I thought someone would say amen.
Amen.
And be led forth in peace.
Amen.
The mountain and the hill before you shall break forth into singing.
Amen.
And all the trees of the field shall clap their hands in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jeremiah chapter 30 verse 17. Jeremiah 30 verse 17. It says, for I will restore health unto you, and your wound I will heal, declare the Lord, because they have called you outcast. It is Zion, for whom no one cares. Instead, in 3 John 1 and 2, 3 John 1 and 2, he said, beloved, I pray that all may go well with you, and that you may be in good health as it goes well with your soul. It will all go well with you this year in the name of Jesus. You will be in good health in the name of Jesus. The Lord will restore your health in the name of Jesus. The Lord will heal you in the name of Jesus. You will not be called an outcast in the name of Jesus. This year, Lord, the Lord will meet your need. your spiritual need, your material need, your physical need, your mental need, in the name of Jesus. In Psalm 107 verse 20, the Bible says, he sent out his word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. The word of God this year will heal you. In the name of Jesus. The word of God will deliver you. The word of God will restore you. In the name of Jesus. In Psalm 91. He said, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide in the shelter of the Almighty. My prayer for you is that you will dwell in the secret place of the Most High.
Amen.
You will dwell in the secret place of the Most High.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. And you abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. He said, I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust. The Lord will be your refuge in the name of Jesus. The Lord will be your fortress in the name of Jesus. You will trust in the Lord this year in the name of Jesus. He says, surely he shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the noise of pestilence. The Lord will deliver you in the name of Jesus. The Lord will deliver you in the name of Jesus from the snare of the fowler and from noise of pestilence in the name of Jesus. He said, he shall cover you with his feather, and under his wing shall not trust. His wing shall be your shield and your butler. The Lord will cover you under his wing in the name of Jesus. The Lord will preserve you. The Lord will keep you in the name of Jesus. Can we just ask on our feet as we pray this after the next 5-10 minutes? I want you to just go before God and ask for the mercy of God. Ask for the mercy of God. Ask for the purging. Ask that the Almighty God will cleanse and purify you this hour in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, for we have all sinned and conscious of his glory. It says, in sin we were conceived. Go before God and ask for the mercy of God. Cry unto God that, Lord, whatsoever will hinder my prayer this hour, Father, take them away from me in the name of Jesus. That even as we begin to pray, say, Lord, whatsoever will hinder my prayer, Lord, Father, take them out in the name of Jesus. Ask God to purge you. Ask God to cleanse you. Ask God to purify you. Ask God to wash you anew. The Bible says we have all sinned and conscious of the glory of God. Go before God, say, Lord, be merciful unto me. Say, Lord, be merciful unto me. Say, Lord, purge me of every unrighteousness. Say, Lord, cleanse me. Say, Lord, purify me. Say, Lord, wash me anew. In the name of Jesus. Cry unto God. Cry unto God that the Almighty God will be merciful unto you in the name of Jesus. That the mercy of God will overwhelm you and your household in the name of Jesus. Cry unto God. In Isaiah 54 verse 15, he said, behold, they shall surely gather together, but not by me. He said, which shall gather together against thee shall fall for your sake. You will cry unto God that as men that will gather for your sake to do you harm, that they will fall for your sake this year in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and cry to God. The Bible said, the Bible did not say they will not gather. You know that they will surely gather. So you cry unto God that every gathering for my sake this year to do me harm, that the Almighty God will discomfit them in the name of Jesus. Pray that you will not fall into the trap of your enemy. You will not fall into the trap of the wicked in the name of Jesus. That the Almighty God will shield you from every harrow of the wicked in the name of Jesus. That men that gather for your sake, they will fall for your sake in the name of Jesus. Pray that you will not be dismayed. Pray that you will not be confounded. Pray that you will not be put to shame in the name of Jesus. Pray that your household will not be put to shame in the name of Jesus. Pray that your wife, your husband, your children will not be put to shame in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and cry unto God. As I do say here, that the sealed mouth is a sealed destiny. Is the sealed mouth is a sealed destiny. Cry unto God that your destiny will not be truncated. The destiny of your children will not be truncated. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and cry unto God. Say, Lord, Do not allow my destiny to be truncated. Do not allow my destiny of my children to be truncated. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and cry unto God. Pray that you will fulfill destiny. That your children will fulfill destiny. In the name of Jesus. Pray that you will walk in the volume of books that are written concerning you. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and cry unto God. Say, Lord, let me walk in the volume of book that are written concerning me and my household. In the name of Jesus. Cry unto God that you will fulfill destiny, that you will walk in the will of God concerning you in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and cry unto God. Open your mouth and cry unto God. Pray that the hand of the Lord will mightily upon you this year in the name of Jesus. In Ezekiel chapter 1 verse 3, he said the word of the Lord came expressly unto Ezekiel, the priest, the son of Buzi, in the land of the Chaldeans by the name of Sheba. And the hand of the Lord was upon him. Say, Lord, let your hand be upon me this year. Let the hand of God be upon me this year. The hand of God is the hand of righteousness. The hand of God is the hand of healing. The hand of God is the hand of deliverance. The hand of God is the hand of restoration. Say, Lord, let your hand be upon me mightily this year. Let the hand of God be upon my children. Let it be upon my household mightily in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and cry unto God that the hand of the Lord will mightily upon you in the name of Jesus. Cry unto the Lord that his hand will be mightily upon you in the name of Jesus. In Ezekiel chapter 8 verse 7, the Bible says, he brought me to the door of the court, and when I looked, behold a hole in the wall. Then said he unto me, Son of man, dig now in the wall. And when I had digged in the wall, behold, there was a door. And he said unto me, go in and build the wicked abomination that they were there in. So I went in and I saw, behold, every form of crippled things, abominable beasts, and all the idols of the house of Israel prepared upon the wall. And there stood before them 70 men of ancient of the house of Israel, and the beasts of them stood Jazariah, the son of Shaphan, and every man in the censer, and his son, and the thick cloud. You will cry unto God that every door of wickedness, that the Almighty God will close them this year concerning you and your household in the name of Jesus. Say, Lord, every door of wickedness, every door of affliction that I've been opened upon my life, say, Lord, I close them this hour in the name of Jesus. Begin to seal those doors with the blood of Jesus, that no door of wickedness shall be opened concerning you, concerning your household this year in the name of Jesus. Say, no door of wickedness shall be opened concerning you in the name of Jesus. That every door of affliction, that the Almighty God will shut them this year in the name of Jesus. That every door of sorrow, the Almighty God will shut them this year concerning you and your household in the name of Jesus. You will not be sorrowful, you will not be mournful, you will not be afflicted in the name of Jesus. The Bible says that digger the pits and fall there. Why not cry to that every pit the enemy must have dug for me, that they will fall into it in the name of Jesus. He said that only the stone shall roll back unto him. That every sort of wickedness, say back to sender. Back to sender. Doors of affliction shall not be open concerning you this year, shall not be open concerning your household this year in the name of Jesus. Cry unto God. Cry unto God. Cry unto God. Pray unto God that while you have been forsaken, while you have been forgotten, you will be remembered in the name of Jesus. Say, Lord, this year remember me. Say, Lord, this year remember me, Lord. Remember my good work. Remember my sacrifice in your vineyard in the name of Jesus. Cry unto God that you will be remembered this year. You will not be forsaken. You will not be forsaken. You will not be forgotten in the name of Jesus. It took David to remember Mephibosheth. Say, Lord, remember me. Say, Lord, remember me. Say, Lord, remember me. When Mephibosheth was remembered, the Bible said, continually at the king's table. Say, Lord, this year, Lord, let me continually at your table. Let me continue at your table in the name of Jesus. Pray that this year you eat continually at the Lord's table in the name of Jesus. Say, Lord, this year let me continue at your table in the name of Jesus.
Pray that the Almighty God will meet your need, your spiritual need, your material need, your physical need, in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and cry unto God that you will continue in the temple this year in the name of Jesus. That you will not lack anything good in the name of Jesus. Pray that you will be like a tree that is planted by the river of water that will bring forth the fruit in season in the name of Jesus. Cry unto God, Lord. Say, Lord, let me be like a tree that is planted by the river of water that will bring forth the fruit in season in the name of Jesus. Pray that this year you will bring forth your fruit in season. You will bring forth your fruit in season. You will bring forth your fruit in season. In the name of Jesus. Cry out to God that the Almighty God will meet your need in the name of Jesus. He is the prophet. Say, Lord, meet all my need this year. Meet all my need this year. In the name of Jesus. In Isaiah chapter 8 verse 10, the Bible says, take counsel together and it shall come to none. It says, speak the word, it shall not stand, for God is with us. Cry unto God that every counsel of the wicked concerning you not will stand in the name of Jesus. It was this same God that caused the counsel of Ahithophel to be taken. Say, Lord, every counsel from the pit of hell, none shall stand concerning you and your children in the name of Jesus. Pray that only the counsel of the Lord will stand concerning you in the name of Jesus. Pray for your children, that the Almighty God will preserve your children in the name of Jesus. The Almighty God will preserve their going out and their coming in the name of Jesus. Cry unto God that this period of fasting and prayer, that your fasting will not be in vain, that your prayer will not be in vain. Pray that the Almighty God will meet all your need in the name of Jesus. Pray that this period you will serve God, you will do the will of God in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless your name. Lord, we honor your name. Lord, we adore your name. Indeed, you are a faithful God. Indeed, you are a kind God. Glory to you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Can you just grab someone by your side? Just grab someone by your side. I just want to pray for that person. Oh, Marcus Sotorianda. I just want to pray for that person that holds it. That person will be fruitful this year. Pray that person will serve the Lord this year. Pray for revival in the life of the person you are holding. In Luke chapter 24, verse 45, it says, open ye their understanding, that they might understand the scripture. Say, Lord, open the understanding of the person you are holding. That the Lord will open their understanding this year in the name of Jesus. Say, Lord, open your understanding of the person that wants to open their understanding. How that the famine of the word of God will be far from them. Pray for the person that you are holding, that they will serve God this year, that they will do the will of God this year, that they will obey God this year in the name of Jesus. Pray for revival for their life in the name of Jesus. Pray that the Almighty God will meet all their needs, their spiritual need, material need, physical need, in the name of Jesus. Pray that the Almighty God will uphold them in the name of Jesus. Pray that the wisdom and knowledge of God will be manifested in their life in the name of Jesus. Pray that goodness and grace will be their portion in the name of Jesus. Pray that the Almighty God will restore that they have lost in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Can you just hold someone else again? You still program as you are holding. In Isaiah chapter 44, verse 25, the Bible said, they frustrated the token of the lion and made the lion mad. He turned the wise men backward and made the knowledge of foolishness. Pray for that person that concerning this person I'm holding. that the Lord will frustrate every token of the liar concerning that person in the name of Jesus. Say, Lord, frustrate every token of the liar concerning this brother, this sister in the name of Jesus. Say, Lord, frustrate every token of the liar concerning them in the name of Jesus. Pray that the Almighty God will make every crooked place straight in their life in the name of Jesus. He said, I will go before thee and make the crooked place straight. I will break in pieces the gate of brass and cut asunder the bars of iron. Say, Lord, make every crooked place straight in their life in the name of Jesus. Pray that the light of God will shine to that life in the name of Jesus. Say, Lord, let your light shine to every dark spot of their life. And begin to illuminate every dark part of their life in the name of Jesus. Say, Lord, shine your light into their life. Shine your light into their life. Shine your light into their life. In the name of Jesus. The Bible says, let there be light. And there was light. And the Bible says, Lord, my light was good. The Bible says, I separated light from darkness. Say, Lord, separate the life of this one from darkness. Let the light of God shine into their life. Every dark spot of their life, God shine into every dark spot of their life in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Almighty God. Blessed be your name, our Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Father, we thank you this hour. Lord, we bless your name, Lord. Father, we thank you for the point to share your word this hour to pray, Lord. As we have said to your ears, you will hear our cry, you will hear our supplication in the name of Jesus. Lord, you will meet our need, spiritual need, material need, physical need, in the name of Jesus. Your children will not lack anything good. Spiritually, they will not lack. Materially, they will not lack. Physically, they will not lack. In the name of Jesus. As they go, you go ahead of them in the name of Jesus. And make every crooked place straight in their life. Thank you, Almighty God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. God have mercy. And before we share the grace, my brother, can we just pray with you, please? Then I will pray for first timer. If you're not praying, just pray. Can we just pray with you with him? I've just stayed for you towards our from sight to his life. Pray that he shall be well with him in the name of Jesus. Pray that the glory of God will overwhelm him in the name of Jesus. Pray that we will not lack anything good in the name of Jesus. Pray that as he goes, and Lord will go with him. And no matter what we are surrounding in the name of Jesus. But that is coming here today, we know it for good. In the name of Jesus. We know why you in the blood of Jesus. Why you're going out in the blood of Jesus. It is well with you. You will be planted in the house of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. As mountains surround Jerusalem, no matter who surround you with his blessing. In the name of Jesus. You will know the Lord the more. You will serve the Lord. You will do his will. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Welcome to our church. Please, God. Can we share the grace of fellowship? The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the same fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forever. Amen. Surely, goodness and grace shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. It is well with me, it is well with my family, it is well with my assembly. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise God. Let's call those who are not in the church and ask after.